The Marine Corps and Navy tested new technology at Red Beach, California on April 24th through April 28th. This was the Ship-to-Shore Maneuver Exploration and Experimentation Advanced Naval Technology Exercise 2017.
Drop the ramp, then let the thing off, ramp back up, then you can worry about changing it over. You're not going anywhere from that point. Any questions about any of that?
The exercise's goal was to identify technology that can minimize marine casualties on the battlefield.
All right, we lost people watching. Today they're not. You don't want to be, you're going to be attacked. You don't be like, survive later.
Hundreds of scientists, investors, and spectators attended the exercise where the Marine Corps tested autonomous vehicles, unmanned aerial vehicles, and new communication systems. A mobile device that uses an application called the Kill Switch. It lets Marines use smartphones to locate each other, pinpoint enemy forces, and call for airstrikes.
Squad leader in front of me, conferring with his other leadership via his kill switch tablet, providing shared situational awareness to not only the targets that his UAVs are seeing that he's controlling, also blue force tracking to ensure that more weight.
The program requires a Marine to carry a lightweight receiver on his back and input data into a smartphone equipped to the front of his flak jacket.
Go.
Unmanned Amtracks will be able to deliver MUTs and drones from the ship to shore while keeping Marines out of the line of fire. The Multi-Utility Tactical Transport Vehicle, or MUT, was another major display at the exercise. The MUT comes in different models, geared for different tasks. These are used to carry heavy loads, which would normally weigh down Marines on patrol. And this MUT is mounted with a 50 caliber machine gun. It's planned to be used at the front lines to provide Marines with powerful, suppressing fire. There's also a sea ground MUT variant that will be able to carry out independent amphibious landings. The exercise also showcased the new unmanned aerial vehicle that takes off and lands vertically. It has infrared capabilities that allow it to accurately detect ground enemy forces at any time of the day. It will also collect data for Marines and sailors operating it. The Commandant of the Marine Corps, General Robert Neller, attended the fifth day of the exercise. He often stresses the need for the Marine Corps' technological advancement.
Part of this process is not just the technology, it's figuring out a way to prototype, iterate, come up with something better, and do it as fast as we can. There's rules, and we can't ignore those rules, but we got to be able to do things faster because we need some of these capabilities. We need them now, not 10 years from now.
Yeah, we're going to make sure we got a full security.